that would be a store-bought lemon.
Yeah.
But you get it at the grocery store, right? Say hello to a homegrown Meyer lemon in comparison. These suckers are big enough you can fool people into thinking they're oranges. Look at that. You'd swear that was an orange. No belly button though. It is indeed a lemon.
Oh, here's an orange.
Oh, okay. So here's an orange. Here's a lemon. Deceptively the same.
Oh, that thing is the orange of the neighbor orange. It's larger.
No, that's not. That's the top. See? That's where the stem goes on the lemon. The stem on the oranges. They look exactly the same. It's only when you turn them over.
Belly button.
The orange has a belly button. The lemon don't. And by the way, this lemon is heavier than this orange. Whew. Okay, the first pan of lemons. So we just keep on going, but there's peace of mind. Try to get the stems off if you can. Just that much less to wind up in the sink. When it feels like work again. So baby, we should find ourselves. One dish pan full of lemons. A little place to stop for a while.
And get above the things that made us feel this way.
And if you're lucky, where you got pricked by the lemon tree from the thorns doesn't hurt that much because you're so excited about the next step of lemon processing.
However, some of us aren't that lucky. Okay, so it's rinse, chop, peel, press, repeat. When it feels like work again. Yeah, when it feels like work again. The trick is to get lemon and juice in the thing, because look, it's running through and filling up the jug already. So look, you got to go at a pace here. You don't want to overflow things. But that's the free lemon juice from all the chopping and peeling, see? Already can see it in the bottom of the jug. Okay, now, we gotta get the fruit to go in the press.
Where the juice went.
Has one tried to escape?
Yes, one did get away. He's going into the compost pile.
Okay, now, the thing's juicing itself. There we go. Let's do another batch.
Yep.
Put it on top of there. All right. The pressing process has proceeded. And we're slowly screwing this big screw down, which pushes this lid down into this wooden bucket and squirts out lemon juice into the gallon. He says, while not squeezing. So the deal is you just turn this thing. The lid goes down, the juice comes out, you just go till you can't no more. In the meantime, your able-bodied Yankee assistant is quartering lemons. So the process goes on.
Yes, production goes on at all times.
And as you can see, there's a good little stream of lemon juice trickling into the jug. kind of reminds me of other assorted liquids distilled into jugs. But we won't go there.
Yes, we digress.
All right, Cappy's helpful hint that I usually forget every time I use the press. You will note that I folded the top of the bag over on top of the lemons I'm gonna squeeze. If you don't, they squirt out from between the lid and it makes just a big sloppy mess. So, squeeze all the goody out of it. One thing's for sure, the little lemon press sure does a good job. Made of pretty stern stuff. You can put a squeeze on it. Yeah, I guess that's about it. One more round. Just to say I did.
Get more.
Oh yeah. Gene, I quit. Might check your water over there. I'm not backseat driving. I just noticed it was kind of broke.
Ow!
Now we have it fine.
Oops, I better stop dancing.
Yeah, guys, we're down to a quarter of the lemons.
Yeah, but
out of the wheelbarrow.
Moving them out of one container, put them somewhere else.
Well, that's called production production enthusiasm.
Right. Just because the wheelbarrow's not full don't mean the same thing.
Oh!
That Zydeco.
Shows we're getting closer and closer.
A little Zydeco music to squeeze lemons by. Even crawfish got soul. I squeeze that sucker down in there so good and don't want to come out. Squeezed it. So I like to never got the lid out of there. Now we have a bag of lemon pulp. Well squeezed bag of lemon pulp. Oh, just in time too. The jug's full.
We saved a few rinds, put them in there for the flavor, for the extra flavor.
Yeah, we picked the pretty ones. Some of the lemons are all snicked up from birdie snickings. So
the birds like it for their feathers.
We put the pretty ones. We put the pretty ones in the press and squeeze a little lemon zest into the fluid. All right, that's good for now, dear.
Yeah.
Excuse me. I'm going to take my little juicing bag and turn it inside out.
And I just cleaned the water. Oh, put it on that end.
I'm not adding this to the wall.
Okay, here I am taking the final pan of lemons out of the wheelbarrow. Tis a happy moment indeed.
Well done. You got room, Don?
Yep.
I had to sit down again.
We got room, no problem.
I had to sit down again.
Can I dump these in, honey?
Yeah.
Okay, relax yourself. I don't want to splash your glasses anymore than I have to.
I had to sit down for a moment and give my lower back a break.
There, about that. Okay, yes, so that now gets the, into the washing step.
What, that was the last bucket?
Yes, this is the last bucket.
No more lemons in the wheelbarrow.
That's an affirmative.
Hallelujah. That's an accomplishment.
Yes. And get a picture of the clock. It's 3:30 in the afternoon on the day that we started.
That's amazing, because by myself, Peggy and I...
We're well into the wee hours.
What time did we start?
11?
So midnight.
11.
Something like that. Wow. Being in a measly 4.5 hours, we damn near got them licked. Of course, we're not done yet.
Yes, we're fired.
It's all got to be chopped and squeezed, and then we got a portion of the little bottles.
We'll be done in time for dinner.
That's what I'm talking about. Whew. Not only is it the last squeezing, but it's the last jug. And as you can see, she's pretty well topped off.
And this is the last jug of what? 9 total gallon jugs?
I guess 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the 9th.
That's
number 9.
This is the 9th. Okay, well, here it is about 5.5 hours later. 6 full gallons of lemon juice and 23 16-ounce water bottles. Pretty good haul this year. Total of about 9 gallons. So not a bad haul. And God bless our good friends from coming to help us do it.
You sound worn out.
I am worn out. My back hurts. My hands are, I'd say pruny, but I guess we'll call them lemony.
Right at this point.
Alright.
Tired but happy.
Feel like I could work again.